next question is, do you think, I'm sorry, next question is, do you drink or smoke? You look fun to hang out with. I am very fun to hang out with, to be honest with you. I do not smoke. I've never smoked when I was younger. If I'd go out to have a drink, so yes, I do drink socially and once in a while. And I'm talking about when I was way younger. Guys, you're gonna have to excuse my stomach. It's grumbling. Anything I eat, it always makes like these crazy noises. Anyway, so yes, I do drink occasionally, every so often. And no, I don't smoke. But when I was younger, in my 20s, anytime I would go out to have a drink, a social drink, I'd have a smoke, a cigarette. That's it. I've never smoked anything other than a cigarette.
Says
Trust me. Alright. Whoa. She asked me a few questions. Okay, so it says, number one, Jackie, have you ever used any Clinique skincare or Clinique makeup? If so, what's your favorite? Yes, I have. When I was way younger, my mom, actually, I think if I'm not mistaken, that was one of my very first skincare lines that I ever used. And my mom bought it for me. I think I was like 13 or 14. And it was, you know, Clinique has like level 1, 2, and 3, or phase 1, 2, and 3, something like that. Well, she got me that. And she got me the soap, the face soap, the toner, and the moisturizer. And I used to hate the toner because if, you know, I had some acne, so I would make my skin burn, like it would burn because I had acne and I would pick on my freaking skin. So I would hate that. But once I would put on that moisturizer, I felt so much better. That moisturizer was live. It's a really, really good moisturizer. Do I have a favorite from Clinique? No, I do not, because I no longer use Clinique, but I did when I was really, really young. And like I said, I think it was, if I'm not mistaken, it was my first line of skincare that my parents purchased for me. Second question she asks is, how do you feel about Kylie Cosmetics and KKW Beauty? Worth the hype?
Advice for watching what you eat during quarantine. My current struggle, oh baby girl.
it's been a major struggle. So what I try to do every day, I get hungry, and I'm usually someone that doesn't get hungry often. If I have a good breakfast, like I try to keep my breakfast, I don't do diets in particular, but I try to like alternate like different methods, for example keto, carb cycling, things like that. So for my breakfast, I try to consume like protein and fats. So if I eat, like, let's say I eat 3 pieces of like hard salami and a hard boiled egg, for example, I'm good. I'll be good for like the rest of the day. Like, I have to remind myself, okay, Jackie, it's time for lunch. You need to eat, or sometimes even dinner, because I will not get hungry. But during this quarantine, it's like, bitch, like, stop. Like, I just ate. Like, you're not damn hungry. But I think that goes for everyone, because my girls, my kids are the same way. Like, they're not huge eaters like that. And it's like, they're constantly asking for a snack, and I'm like, why? You just had a snack. I don't know if it's because their mind is a little bored, or because they know that we have those extra snacks there that they can have, but it's crazy. My suggestion, as hard as it is, try to keep your mind occupied, guys. Sometimes hunger is not really hunger, it really is boredom. Our natural instinct is to, unfortunately, turn to food. Now, I'll tell you this other thing. If you're feeling hungry, go for like the healthy snacks. Go for like veggie sticks. Go for like fruit, yogurt. But I know it doesn't work like that. And lots of water. A lot of water. Like, for example, water with lemon helps you curb your appetite a lot. Especially when you know you're craving stuff that you shouldn't be craving, such as like chips and like candy bars and stuff like that, candy. Warm water with like half of lemon juice, yellow lemon juice, that helps a lot, because what it does is it reduces the fat on your liver, and when you detox your liver, you don't crave as much junk as you do when you haven't detoxed. So, and detox, don't do it too often, because it can be dangerous. But girl, I feel your struggles, and look, I'm right here with you. But just take a deep breath and say, I had my breakfast, I had my little snack, I don't need to be eating again. If you know you shouldn't be eating again now, if you get hungry and you know you haven't eaten more than 4 or 5 hours, then go have yourself a good snack. But try to be wise with your snacking. Thanks for the love, baby girl. Top skincare tips. Exfoliate and moisturize every single day. You can't exfoliate every day, even though they do sell daily exfoliants that are very mild. But you do need to exfoliate at least once or twice a week. Exfoliation is everything. It gets rid of all those dead cells, that dead skin in your skin, on your face, even on your body. And moisturize, no matter how oily your skin is, moisturize your skin according to your skin type. Don't go a day without moisturizing, without cleansing your skin. Wash your face every day. Cleanse your skin every single day. And drink lots and lots and lots and lots of H2O water. cosmopolitan. Like, I love to read magazines, books. I'm not into books like that, but I am currently reading a book that's called... Seafood boils, that's some serious shit. next question is, how long have you been doing makeup? Oh wow, I've been doing makeup for over 20 years. I started doing makeup when I was like 17 and I'm 40. And I started doing it like with friends, and of course my experience wasn't all there. My friends' parents, cousins, moms, cousins, my family. But on a more serious note, like on a pro level, like I'm doing now, I said 10 years that I literally stopped working, stopped my corporate job to work for myself.
Okay.
Just being there with me, and I would hear her like bite her nails, and I was in love, and then she had ASMR in her title of her video, and I'm like, damn, what's ASMR? I looked it up, and I was like, oh, wow, that's what that is. And so I'm like, man, I love this stuff so much. I should do it. And here I am. Give me a sense of adrenaline, which causes me to feel strong and like I'm in control, because I control that emotion, that adrenaline, I control it. So I love roller coasters. What's my favorite dessert? I know this is gonna sound bad, but I don't have a favorite dessert, to be honest with you. But if I had to pick one, it would be flan. That's a Latin kind of like a jello type of dessert. It's called flan, F-L-A-N. Look it up. I don't know how to describe it. It's not my favorite. I don't have favorite desserts. But if I had to pick, it'd have to be flan. Yeah. Okay. And I think this is gonna be it. This is gonna be the last question I'm gonna answer, guys. It says, first I wanna say thank you. I wanna say I love. Let me rewind. I read that wrong. It reads, first I wanna say that I love your channel. Oh, thank you so much, guys. And you're so beautiful. Thank you, thank you. And my question is, how did you and your husband meet? All right, me and my husband met while we were working. I was working for the government, like you all know. He was the building I worked in had a department. It was called the Business Development Department, and they would do professional networking meetings every Mondays. And he would go to those, and that's how I met him. He would then go to the department where I was working, where there was all the computers and all that, and that's how we met. Like, met, that's how we met. He would go to the professional networking meetings, and then he would go into the lab where the computers were, which is like that area where I was at. And that's how we met. So it's like he was working and I was working, but it was at my job that we met. And guys, I have so many other questions, so stay tuned for part two. I really hope you guys enjoyed this quick little video. I thank you all so much for the love, the support.
Stay tuned for part two.
also, let me know if you enjoyed this.